grains are the seeds of a plant. They're their reproductive material. And plants don't make the reproductive material to give away for free to other animals, okay? If they did, they'd become extinct. And so the evolutionary strategy that many plants, particularly cereal grains, have taken to prevent predation is to evolve toxic compounds so that the predator of the seeds can't eat them, so that they can put their seeds in the soil where they're meant to be to grow a new plant and not in the gut of an animal to feed it. That's the problem with the USDA recommendation. They think we're hardwired as a species to eat grains. We don't. You can get by just fine and meet every single nutrient requirement that humans have without eating grains. And grains are absolutely poor sources of vitamins and minerals compared to fruits and vegetables and meat and fish. So in the autism thing, they're looking at wheat and dairy. So they remove wheat and dairy. But I can tell you right now is that potatoes contain substances that cause a leaky gut, as do legumes, just to the extent that gliadin does. So if you've got an autistic kid and you get them off of wheat and dairy, well, good. But if a leaky gut is indeed involved and it is autoimmune related, then you're only halfway there. And you have to get the legumes and you have to get potatoes out of the diet. These saponin-containing foods, we know, cause leaky gut. You can make gluten-free products. You can have gluten-free breads that are made out of rice and potato flour and God knows what else. And they can have even a texture that is similar to bread, but you're still getting a gigantic glycemic load. You're still getting a variety of anti-nutrients that are potentially not very helpful. Humans are good field animals and we're designed to be outside, outdoors, exercising, in the sunshine, eating real nutritious foods.